Halloween, it's such a fun time for many people, especially the kiddos. We have the inside scoop on a haunted house you won't want to miss. Here to give us all the details about her haunted graveyard and tent terror is Stephanie Valgos. Welcome to the show, Stephanie.
Thank you.
Stephanie, now, I've known you for a long time. I did not know you were such a Halloween fan. How did this happen?
Well, I used to live in Danville, and the whole community went all out for Halloween, and there's this one fan favorite house that did cotton candy. It was super cool. That memory's always been stuck in my brain. Fast forward 5 years, I have a daughter of my own. I think I want to be that house. So I go out, I buy a bride and groom, kind of dull. I jazz it all up, give it a boa, little leopard before leopard was cool, top hat, and throw some tombstones out, and voila, matriarchs of the cemetery. It just started a craziness and a madness for me.
Oh my gosh, so this is awesome. So your house is in Turlock, and you totally deck it out in Halloween, but it's pretty scary, and you have different parts of the home that you deck out in Halloween.
Yes, and it's all decked out in Christmas lights. Everyone's like, why Christmas lights? But I love Christmas. My daughter was born on Christmas, but with Christmas, you just take a snowman out and stick it on the lawn. Mm-hmm. With Halloween, I just realized it just gave me the ability to create, push the envelope, do some really fun, artistic kind of things. So it just grew and grew, and I went from a cemetery to a chop shop on the porch to an entire tent now.
Yeah, and now you added a Stranger Things on this kind of tribute on the side of the tent.
Yes, absolutely. My niece Avery's wild about the show. She told me about it. I binged watched it for 5 days, and I'm like, okay, I've got to incorporate it.
So yeah, your tent's right on the driveway. People can come up to your house, do some trick-or-treating, kind of get a haunt, a spook while they're there. Okay, so I would say you're kind of now like this expert in like how to create these Halloween haunted displays. What are like the main pieces if someone, you know, there's still some time, they could deck out their home. What are some things that they should do?
I always tell people lights. The more light, the better. I drive around the neighborhoods, and a lot of times I see houses, and their display just gets lost in the dark. Mm-hmm. And don't be afraid to throw lights on it. Makes it spookier, creates ambiance. And another thing that people don't know about is Tide. Liquid Tide.
Okay, what does that do?
Liquid Tide, if you have black lights, makes everything glow. So just get a paintbrush, start painting stuff with anything white with Tide, and it just pops it, it glows, it's super spooky.
Really? Okay.
Yeah, and I also tell people to think cheap. Like, you can go to the dollar store, buy skeletons, spray paint them neon, throw them under black lights. They look great. And there's a lot of secondhand stores with really cool frames and furniture that
you
can.
So it sounds like you just have to get creative and use things that are around you. We're taking a look at the house. That's a lot of lights. And this is a Halloween display. So tell us about your home. How many people are you expecting? You've been doing this annually.
Yeah, I pass out about 2,000 to 3,000 cotton candies on Halloween.
Wow.
And chocolate at the front porch. I'm actually renting the house the 30th and the 31st. So tonight's the first night. There's a lot of people that can't make it on Halloween, and I just want everyone to be able to stop by and enjoy it. So I run it for 2 nights now.
Okay, so there's a little bit of a foot traffic jam coming through your house, because you have a tent that they can walk through that's on the driveway, and then obviously your house is completely covered. What time and where can they find you?
So I'm on Merchant Lane in Turlock, 4215 Merchant Lane, and it's open from 5 to 10 today, all the way up to November 3rd. I actually run it past Halloween.
Okay, so we'll go through the weekend.
Yes.
Is it scary? Can you bring the little ones?
You can definitely bring the little ones. And there is a way to bypass the tent if you don't want to walk through the tent. So.
And you have some pictures and stuff up on Facebook, so you can search for your Facebook
page.
Absolutely.
It's Steffi V's Haunted Cemetery and Tent of Terror. There's pictures. And if you don't want to go through the chop shop or the crazy cemetery, you can just come up and grab cotton candy.
Oh, that's awesome. I think that's great that you're doing that, building community and making it fun.
Yeah, the community is amazing.
I love that you've taken it to the next level. If you're out there in Turlock, you've got to check out Steffi V's Haunted Graveyard and Tent of Terror. Oh my gosh, I'm getting scared just thinking of it. Thanks for being here, Steph.
Aw, thank you.
This interview involves commercial content. The products and services featured appear as paid advertising.